So today we are going to have the discussion about what we have finished just to working with the files. So just before going to working with the files, we need to understand two things, my dear friend. So actually, the programs of what dear friend, programs are classified into two categories. Programs are classified into what dear friend, classified into two types based on the what dear friend, just based on storage of data. So based on what dear friend, just a storage of the data, based on storage of the data. Based on storage of the data, that is number one. So what you find just a non-persistency programming. Another one is what you find just a persistency programming. See what you mean by persistency programming and what you mean by non-persistency programming. So ladies and gentlemen, actually the programs of what you find just a programs are classified into two categories based on what you find based on storage of data. That is number one is what non-persistency programming. Number two is what dear friend persistency programming. So what do you mean by non-persistency programming, my dear friend? See, non-persistency programs are one in which the result of the program will be stored in the system memory temporarily. I repeat, non-persistency programs are one in which the result of the program will be stored in the system memory temporarily. That is, the values which were passing during executing the program as an input, and the values which you are getting after executing the program as an output, those values will be stored in the system memory temporarily. Such a type of programs are called as what you find non-persistency programming. See, I repeat once again, non-persistency programs are one in which the result of the program will be stored in the system memory temporarily. That is, the values which you are passing during executing the program as an input and the values which you are getting after executing the program as an output, those values will be stored in the system memory temporarily. Sir, in order to store the data permanently, then we need to go with what your friend persistency programming. I hope you understood right. See, non-persistency programs are one in which what your friend result of the program will be stored in the system memory temporarily. That is, the values which you are passing during executing the program as an input and the values which you are getting after executing the program as an output, those values will be stored in the system memory temporarily. That means once the program execution is completed, whatever the inputs are given by you and whatever the outputs are received by you will be discarded. Such a type of programs are called as what DFN, non-persistency programming. Sir, what do you mean by persistency programming, my dear friend? Persistency programs are one in which the result of the program will be stored in the system memory permanently. That is, the values which we are passing during executing the program as an input. Those values required to be stored in the system memory permanently. Okay, that type of programs are called as what dear friend? Persistency programming. I repeat, persistency programs are one in which the result of the program will be stored in the system memory permanently. That is, the values which you are passing during executing the program as an input and the values which you are getting after executing the program as an output, those values will be stored in the system memory permanently. Such a type of programs are called as persistency programming. My dear lovely friend, just persistency programs can be done in two ways. See, persistency programs can be done in how many ways, my dear friend? Two ways. That is, number one, by using what dear friend? By using the files. Number two, using what dear friend? Number two, using what dear friend? Using databases like. Number one, using the files. Number two, by using what dear friend databases. That is the concept. Persistency programs can be done in programming two ways, either by using the files or by using what dear friend databases like. Sir, what is a file, sir? As we know that, sir, files are used to store the data permanently. Files are used to store the data permanently in the particular space in the disk. Files are used to store the data permanently in a particular space on the disk. But okay, friends, just here in the chapter, exclusively we are going to have the discussion about how to write the programs to interact with what your friend just how to write the programs to interact with the files. That is, how to write the program to store the data into the file, how to write the programs to read the data from the file, how to read the data from Excel sheets, some other examples I'm going to cover you. Don't worry. Sir, before going to work with the files, so we need to work with what your friend some common functions which are required to work with the files topic. In that, the very first function is what your friend just to open function. Right, okay, open function. Dear friend, the open function, just to where dear friend, open function required two arguments. One is what dear friend, just a file name. Another one is what dear friend, just a file mode. Very fortunately, the open function will return an object of the class text IO wrapper. It will return an object of the class what dear friend, text IO wrapper, IO text wrapper. So that is what dear friend, just it will return an object of the file class in general terminology, in simple terminology. The open function will return what your friend file class object. Open function will return what your friend file class object. Sir, here that is what your friend just the syntax it will return what your friend it will return file class object. But technically there is a class is what your friend underscore IO text wrapper. There is some technical name will be there for the class file. That is underscore IO text wrapper that I will show you practically. You don't worry. So, but you need to understand, my dear lovely friend, while working with the open function, we require two arguments. One is what dear friend file name, another one is what dear friend file mode. Sir, in order to work with the files, first of all, what you have to do is you have to open the file. So friend, in order to work with the file, open, just we require what dear friend, just two arguments. One is file name, another one is what dear friend file mode. So just what dear friend, let's have a look here. What are the file modes are available? Let me start working with this. The very first one is what dear friend, just to write mode. What do you mean by write mode? This means it will open what dear friend, just it will open the file. It will open the file for the purpose of what dear friend, just for the purpose of writing the data into the file. That's enough. So it will open the file for the purpose of what dear friend, just writing the data into the file. But here one point you are requested to notice, if the specified file is already existed, Then PVM will open what your friend PVM will open the file, open that file, and what your friend just adds new data. PVM will open the file and what your friend and write the data into that file. But in this case, the old data will be erased. Old data will be what your friend just erased. This is a point you are requested to notice it, my dear friend. Actually, write mode. The purpose of write mode is what your friend just write mode will open the file for the purpose of writing the data. Dear friend, if the specified file is already existed, it will open the file and allows to write the new data into it. But unfortunately, in this case, the old data will be erased with what dear friend just simply, the new data will be replaced. Older data is replaced with what dear friend, new data. The older data is replaced with the new data simply. The older data will be gone. That is the case. So this is what dear friend, write mode. I repeat, so in the write mode, it will open the file for the purpose of writing the data. If the specified file is already exist, it will erase old data. It will erase old data and allows to write what new. That is what dear friend, just a write mode. There is a means append mode. Sir, append mode. See, what does this mean? See, friend, just if the specified file is not existed, then PVM will create new file. So PVM will create what your friend PVM will create. Will create a new file, and allows to what your friend allows to write the data into it. Allows to write the data into it. This is a matter. Allows to write the data into it. Okay, if the specified file is not existed, then PVM will create the new file and allows to write the data into it. By chance, if the specified file is already existed, then PVM will allow us to add new data into it. But in this case, the data will be that the old data is not erased. In this case, old data is not erased. This is the point you are requested to observe. Right. See, what is the append mode, sir? In the append mode, if the specified file is already existed, it will open the existed file, allows to write the new data into it. So, dear friend, if the specified file is already existed, it will open the file and allows to write the new data. It will allow us to add the new data to its previous. But if the specified file is not existed, simply it will create the new file and allows to write the data. So this is the case, my dear friend. Well, coming to what dear friend, there is a R. R means what dear friend? Read mode. So read mode, point to be understand, dear friend. So it is a what dear friend? It is a default mode. So what is the default mode of the file in Python is what dear friend? Read mode. See, in case you fail to specify the file mode, the Python automatically will open the file in the read mode only. It will open the file in what dear friend? Read mode only. Good friend, it will open the file for the purpose of reading the data. One more point, my dear friend, if the specified file is not existed, then PVM will raise. So just if the specified file is not existed, then PVM will raise an exception, will raise an error. That is what your friend file not found error. You'll be getting what your friend file not found error exception will be raised. So just what is the default mode of the files in Python, sir? Read mode. Okay, it will open the file for the purpose of reading the data. If the specified file is not existed, then PVM will raise file not found error. That is the point. So, dear friend, there is a one more mode is there called what dear friend? Just there is a exclusive. That is what dear friend exclusive. Exclusive mode. What do you mean by exclusive mode, my dear friend? If the specified file is not existed, then PVM will create a new file and allows to write the data into it. One point you are requested to notice, please. If the specified file is not existed, then PVM will allow, PVM will create a new file and allows to write the data into it. If the specified file is already existed, then PVM will raise an exception. That is what your friend file exists error. You'll be getting what your friend this error. That means exclusive. Exclusive means what your friend just create a file and allows to write the data into it if and only if when the specified file is not existed. Exclusive means what your friend we are requesting the PVM to open the file for the purpose of writing the data if and only if the specified file is not already existed. If the specified file is not already existed. Sir, if the specified file already existed, then what is happened? Then automatically PVM will raise an error. So what error will be raised? PVM will raise file exist error. Yes, file exist error. So just what dear friend, write mode, append mode, read mode, exclusive mode, such a manner that we have something like what dear friend, just a W plus. W plus means what dear friend, write and what dear friend, read. Write and read. R plus is also there. Sorry, A plus is also there. A plus means what dear friend, append and what dear friend, just to read. So based on your application requirements, we can open the files in the different modes. See, when you open the file in write mode, exclusively it will allow us to perform only write operation. But it does not allow you to perform the read operation. But if you want to perform what dear friend, write and read operation, you can use what dear friend, W plus or A plus. W plus means what dear friend, write and read. That means if the specified file is already existed, it will overwrite old data with the new data and also allow for reading the data. It will overwrite old data with the new data and allows for what dear friend, reading the data. That's whereas coming to A plus means what dear friend, A plus, append and read. That means if the specified file is already exist, if the specified file is already exist, it will allow us to add the new data into it and also allow us to read the data into it. Okay, just A plus means what dear friend, if the specified file is already exist, allows to append the new data into it and also allows to read the data from it. Just this is what dear friend, just the file modes. So let's have a one small basic program with just a basic program on these particular points. Let's have a look. In the middle, I'm going to cover you some attributes, some methods. You don't worry about it. So just go with my dear friend. I'm going to the what dear friend, just a new file. So just what dear friend, very first one is, yes, open is the name of the function. With what name you want to create? I want to create one file with the name data1.txt. What purpose? Writing purpose. So okay, just it returns an object of the class. It will return what file object. It will return file object, but technically the class name for the file is different. Technically, the class name for the file is different. If you want, you can see my dear friend printer. The type of F is what dear friend, type of F. When you write like this, you'll be getting what dear friend, it will return, it will display the class name of the file. Let me open. I just want to go with what dear friend, just a file example 1.py. So control S, then go to the run menu and click on run module so that this code will be executed. Have you seen my dear friend? So class _io.textwrapper. This is the class name for the file. This is the class name for what dear friend file. If you notice that, there is a what dear friend class _io.textivo_wrapper is the name of the class for the file. You know that in Python, everything will be stored in the form of object. For every object, there is a class. But what is the file object? File object class is what _io is a module. .textivo_wrapper is the name of the class. Very good, sir. Sir, I would like to check. Now, just I would like to check what is the name of this file? Of course, data1.txt. If you want, you can also check that. That is what your friend file name is. F.name. Control S. When Control S is a shortcut key for save, go to the run menu and click on run module. You'll be getting what dear friend file name. So there is a what dear friend just here. You'll be getting what dear friend file name is data1.txt. So data1.txt. Same way, if you want to check what is the file mode is what dear friend f.mode. So when you run this, it will return what mode that file is. Oh, the file is opened in which mode? Write mode. So this is what dear friend, it will return the mode of the file. In which mode the file is opened, that will be displayed. Oh, if you want to check, if you want to ask your PVM, is that file is opened in write form, a writable form, a readable form, which file you can check it out. I have a question to the Python. Is file readable? Is file readable? Readable? Readable is a what dear friend, just is file is what dear friend, just a readable. Readable, just a readable. You know, I have a question to the Python. F dot just what your friend just readable, just what your friend just when you run this, it will return what your friend true if the file is readable, otherwise it will return false. I'm sorry, it is a readable, writable is a function. Sir, readable function, okay, readable function will return what your friend true if the file is readable. But is this a file is readable? No, it is a writable, so it will return what your friend false, false, like this. Sir, I want to check, is that file is writable? Yes. So dear friend, is file writable? Writable is a question to the Python. F dot writable, f dot writable. Yes, just it will return a true if the file is writable. Otherwise, it will return what dear friend just a true. So just what dear friend, if it returns what dear friend, it will return a true if the file is what dear friend writable. Otherwise, it will return what dear friend just a false. Of course, this file is in which mode? Write mode only. Write mode only. Okay, is this a file readable? No, this file is not readable. So you'll be getting what your friend false. Is file writable? Of course, it is true. It is writable. This is a case like this, my dear lovely friend. Well, coming to what your friend want only, I'm changing this file mode to what your friend R. Then what your friend control S to save. Then go to the run menu. You can see what is the file name, sir. File name is data1.txt. What is the file mode, sir? Read mode. Is file readable? True, sir. Is file readable? True, sir. Is file writable, sir? No. It is not writable because you have opened the file in read mode. Read mode, sir. When you write W plus, is that file is writable? Of course. Okay. Is that file readable? True. Is that file writable? True. Because read and write. You can check it out, dear friend. In this case, W plus means what, dear friend? Is file writable? Yes, true. Is file writable? True. That is a way we can find what dear friend just some properties like. Right. Such a manner, we have one more attribute is there. Is file closed? Is file closed is a question to the Python. F dot what dear friend closed? Closed is an attribute. Closed is an attribute. It is not a function. So it will return a true if the file is closed. Otherwise, it will return what dear friend false. I repeat. Closed is an attribute of the class file. It will return true if the file is closed. If the file is closed, otherwise it will return what dear friend? Otherwise it will return false. Now is that file is closed? No, this file is still open. That is the reason you'll be getting what dear friend? You can check it out like, is file closed? False. No, that file is not closed yet. Still it is what dear friend? Just open the mode only. That's it. Sir, can I close the file, sir? Can I close the file, sir, dynamically? Yes, we can close the file also. What is that now? F.close method is there. See, close method will close the file which is already open. Close method will close the file which is already open. Yes, no, I want to check really is file is closed. Is file is closed is my question to the Python. Is file is closed to the Python? Just here's a question. F dot what dear friend just closed. F dot closed. It will return a true no. Because now this moment you have closed this file. Then go to the run menu and click on run module. You can see this. Is file is closed true. Because we have closed that file like that. We have closed that file. That is a way. So based on your requirement, we can work. So just what dear friend, name is an attribute. Mode is an attribute. Readable is a method, writable is a method, closed is an attribute, close is a method. These all are from where? From text IO wrapper class. Text IO wrapper class is nothing but that is the technical name for the file class. That is the technical name for the what your friend file class. File class. I hope you understood right, gentlemen. See, in this particular case, my dear lovely friend, what is it now? So, name is a what your friend, just a name. Name is an attribute. Name is an attribute of what dear friend? Attribute of file class. File class. File class. It will return. Yeah. It will return what dear friend? It will return name of the file. Name of the file. That's enough. Name is a what dear friend? Name is an attribute. So it is a what dear friend? It is an attribute. It is an attribute of a file class. It will return name of the file. Name of the file. Such a manner mode. So it will return what your friend simple. It will return the mode of the file. The mode of the file means which mode the file is open. whether it's write mode or read mode or write plus mode, exclusive mode, what mode that file is opened. There is a whatever friend closed, it will return. It will whatever friend just a simple, it will return it true. It will return whatever friend, it will return it true. If the file, if the specified, if the file is whatever friend, file is closed. If the file is closed, otherwise it will return whatever friend, it will return the false. It will return whatever friend, just false, right? Name will return what your friend just will return. Will return what your friend name of the file. Name of the file like mode. Mode means what your friend it will return what your friend just it will return the file mode. It will return the mode of the file or it will return file modes. It will return file mode. See closed. It will return so true if the file is closed. Else it will return what your friend sells. It will return false. Ultimately it will return false. This is a point. The next one is what dear friend, these are the file class attributes. These are the what dear friend file class attributes. Well, coming to what dear friend, just a file class methods. Now you are seeing that readable. So readable is a method. Will returns, sir, it will returns what dear friend, will returns true. Will returns what your friend true if it returns a true if the what your friend just specified it. Yes, if the specified file is what your friend, if the specified file is okay readable. If the specified file is what your friend readable. Similarly, writable method is that writable method will returns. Yeah, friend, just what your friend just will returns. Will returns what your friend will returns true. Will returns true if the specified file is readable. If the specified file is what your friend file is readable. Sorry, it's a writable. If the specified file is what your friend writable, like this is a, the specified file is what your friend writable. Such a manner, friend. There is a one more method is there called what your friend close. Simple. It will close the what your friend. It will close the opened file. It will close the opened file. That's enough. Very simple, friend. It will close the opened files. Okay. This is the what your friend opened file. That's enough. So like this, what your friend name, mode, closed, or attribute from the file class, are readable, writable, and close. These are the methods of the what your friend file class. Okay, I hope now you guys got the point up to this is very clear, gentlemen. I hope you guys got the point up to this, please.